Hello, so here I am at the Giraffe restaurant at King's Cross, having just been to the British Library with my wife Rachel to see the Russia 100, British Library expedition. Oh, this is what comes of me doing a reverse image. So, hold it in front of the mirror, the Russia 100 exhibition at the British Library. Very informative and worth the money. All £13.50. And yeah, it kind of hits home a few things. It hasn't told you, if you looked at the Russian Revolution and the Civil War that followed, both are very much interconnected. It doesn't tell you anything new, so, but it does give things that are more detailed, and it does hit home how basically part of the reason the Soviet communism succeeded as long as it did, initially did in the Civil War, was simply because there was no strong alternative coming forward other than more of the same or a form of brutal nationalism led by Admiral Kolchak. And because the White Army was of varying types, and because of the result disparity, you know, across Russia, that was how I personally think the Soviet Union was able to hold and to keep its iron grip. And also, of course, there is the Cheka, the terror group, as well, would have had an effect, etc. But as we all, you know, the lead up to the revolution was a long time in coming. But the reason the Soviets were able to hold on it was the illiteracy and the poverty and the lack of viable alternative. And I think those are very much lessons we need to learn today in our politics. When we oppose something, we've got to offer a positive alternative, not just say this is wrong and wrong. We need to make sure we're fairly united, and we need to make sure that we have something more cohesive. And in spite of Allied backing, the White Army did not have a proper cohesive alternative from what I've seen, if you look at the general picture. And that's it. And nice afternoon. I hope you have a good weekend. Cheers.